When you hear a show tune from the great white way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street. You
a good man, Charlie Brown. You're the kind of reminder we need. You have humility, nobility, and a sense of honor that are very rare indeed. You're a good man, Charlie Brown, and we know you will go very far. Yes, it's hard to believe, almost frightening to conceive, what a good man you are. You were kind to all the animals and every little bird. With a heart of gold, you believe what you're told.
Every single solitary word.
You bravely face adversity. You're cheerful through the day. You're thoughtful, brave, and courteous.
And you also have some faults, but for the moment, let's just say that
you're a good man, Charlie Brown. You're a prince, and a prince could be king. With a heart such as yours, you could open any doors. You could go out and do anything. You could be king, Charlie Brown. You could be king.
If only you weren't so wishy-washy.
Well, there's nothing wishy-washy about that song. I wish people had sung that song to me when I was in sixth grade. Hello, this is Larry Maslon, a good man, I hope. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 WLIWFM, Long Island's only signature, one-of-a-kind, warm puppy NPR station. We are beginning... Believe it or not, we are beginning our 12th year on the air every Sunday at 3 o'clock. So first, a warm welcome to all our listeners, both new and old. And I thought we'd start this decade or this year off with a show that meant a lot to me, probably means a lot to you. And it's the intersection of two things I love dearly, the American musical theater and the American comic books, comic strips, and was there ever a better comic strip than Peanuts, which was created and drawn and written for five decades, 50 years, from 1950 to 2000, by Charles M. Sparky, as his friends called him, Charles M. Schulz, who celebrated his 100th birthday back in November. And we had a lot going on at the end of 2022. So we are doing this as a tribute to him at the beginning of 2023. Well, that was the opening number to You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, from the concept album. Yeah, how about that? From 1966. And we will take a tour through all the many different musical versions and ways in which Charlie Brown and Snoopy and Linus and Lucy and Schroeder and all their pals inspired people in show business. So you think that You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, the Off-Broadway musical, would have been the first, but it wasn't. There was a concept album of several, 1962, with dialogue from the Peanuts cartoon with Arthur Siegel, who was a pianist, and Kay Ballard as Lucy. So here is a selection from that with some very typical kids' record music from the early 1960s. 1962, Kay Ballard, one of our faves, as Lucy from the Peanuts album.
Wait. Don't go away, Charlie Brown. What are all those stars up there?
Well, that's the Big Dipper.
And I suppose over there is the Little Dipper?
Uh-huh.
That Charlie Brown sure has some imagination.
Well, I'm not going to let you bother me, Lucy. The stars are too beautiful tonight. Look at all the stars. Did you ever see so many? They're all over. The sky is covered with stars. Stars, stars, stars as far as you can see. I wonder how many there are.
10. 101, 102, 103, 104.
Gee, I thought you'd have given up by this time.
Oh, no, sir. When I get started on something really worthwhile, I never give up.
Well, if you're going to count all these stars, I think I'd better help you.
Well, I appreciate this, Charlie Brown.
Have you counted that little one up there?
Which little one? That one?
No, that little one over there.
Over there?
No, there.
Oh, you mean the little one next to the chartreuse one?
No, that little one right there.
Oh, you mean right there?
No, right there, right up there.
There? Up there?
No, no, there.
There? Oh, there?
No, there.
There?
Yes, there.
What about it?
The stars are beautiful, aren't they? You know what I think? I think that there must be a tiny star out there that is my star. And as I am alone here on Earth among millions of people, that tiny star is out there alone among millions and millions of stars. Does that make any sense, Lucy? Do you think it means anything?
Certainly. It means you're cracking up, Charlie Brown.
Oh, Lucy, I'm so depressed. I don't know what to do.
I'm sorry to hear that, Charlie Brown. Maybe there's something I can do to help. What I think you need most of all is just to come right out and admit all the things that are wrong with you.
Do you really think that will help, Lucy?
Certainly.
All right, I'll try. I'm not very handsome or clever or lucid. I've always been stupid at spelling and numbers. I've never been much playing football or baseball or stickball or checkers or marbles or ping pong. I'm usually awful at parties and dances. I stand like a stick, or I cough, or I laugh, or I don't bring a present, or I spill the ice cream, or I get so depressed that I stand and I scream. Oh, how could there possibly be one small person as thoroughly, totally, utterly blah as me?
Well, that's okay for a starter.
A starter?
Certainly. You don't think that mentioning these few superficial failings is going to do any good, do you? Why, Charlie Brown, you really have to delve. You're stupid, self-centered, and moody.
I'm moody.
You're terribly dull to be with.
Yes, I am. And nobody likes me, not Frida, or Shermie, or Linus, or Schroeder.
Or Lucy.
Or Lucy.
Or Snoopy.
Or Snoopy. Now, wait a minute. Snoopy likes me.
He only pretends to like you because you feed him. That doesn't count.
Or Snoopy. Oh, why was I born just to be one small person as thoroughly, totally, utterly?
Wait! You're not very much of a person.
That's certain.
And yet, there is reason for hope.
There's hope?
For although you are no good at music like Schroeder, or happy like Snoopy, or lovely like me, you have the distinction to be no one else but the singular, remarkable, unique Charlie Brown.
I'm me. I feel much better now. You're a true friend.
There'll be 5 cents, please.
Well, that brilliant little musical scene called The Doctor Is In, Charlie Brown and Lucy, of course, was performed by Clark Gessner and Barbara Minkus. And this was a demo recording. Clark Gessner was a songwriter who was desperate to get Charles Schulz to agree to license Peanuts for a musical theater piece. And Charles Schulz, got to say, in the early 60s, before Peanuts became a international phenomenon, was a little grudging about what he gave his permissions to, so he held back. And oddly enough, while Clark Gessner was waiting for an answer from, where was it, Santa Rosa or Petaluma, wherever he was in California, Charles Schulz had a much bigger project in 1965 on television called A Charlie Brown Christmas. And here is the unforgettable music by Vince Guaraldi, played by the Vince Guaraldi Trio.
Speed, a little more rope, a little more wind, a little more hope. Gotta get this stupid kite to fly. Gotta make sure it doesn't snag, doesn't droop, doesn't drag. Gotta watch out for every little whoops. A little less speed, a little more tack, a little less rise, a little more slack. Gotta keep my wits about me now. Gotta make sure it doesn't get the best of me till I get it in the air somehow. Millions of little kids do it every day. They make a kite and poof, it's in the sky. Leave it to me to have the one fool kite who likes to see a little kid cry. A little less talk, a little more skill, a little less luck, a little more will. Gotta face this fella eye to eye. Now that I've seen you chasing moles, climbing trees, digging holes, wrapping your string on everything passing by, why not fly? Wait a minute, what's it doing? It isn't on the ground. It isn't in a tree. It's in the air. Look at that, it's caught the breeze now. It's past the trees now, with room to spare. Oh, what a beautiful sight. And I'm not such a clumsy guy. if I really try, I can really fly.
What happened to your kite, Charlie Brown? It looks like it ran into a brick wall.
Okay, we're getting closer to the starting line. That was Orson Bean, a musical theater performer and television performer that many people admire. That was an MGM concept album. So that was a second concept album. It's the one Clark Gessner used to sort of float his score to You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. And again, a great song. I mean, so many things in Peanuts. The characters are so strong. The episodes were so clear narratively, made them into very effective musical theater characters. And it wasn't long before Clark Gessner's dream came true at Theater St. Mark's. I don't think it was Theater 80 back then. Theater St. Mark's, or St. Mark's Playhouse, on St. Mark's Place in New York City, a great little off-Broadway theater. And in 1967, the cast came together. And it was a show that ran 4 years. My mother took me to see it. It was the first show my mother took me to see. 1776, I was taken to by a family friend. Anyway, I stray. But if you were a camper at Surprise Lake Camp in 1973 and you were sitting at the Eddie Cantor Playhouse, named after Eddie Cantor, who went there, you would have seen your host, yours truly, sing the following number to, I wouldn't say great acclaim, but to certainly to 11-year-old acclaim. Here is Bob Balaban from the original off-Broadway production as Linus in You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown.
Where's my blanket? When I find the wise guy who took my blanket, I'm gonna give him... Oh, there you are. Delightful. Da 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 da. My blanket and me. It's a cozy sanctuary, but it's far from necessary, 'cause I'm just as self-reliant as before. As a simple demonstration of my independent station, I will go and leave my blanket on the floor. Yes, I'll walk away and leave it, though I know you won't believe it. I'll just walk away and leave it on the floor. Don't ever let me do that again. Gotcha back again. My blanket and me. It's foolish, I know it. I'll try to outgrow it. But meanwhile, there's my blanket and me.
Homework!
Yeah.
A book report on Peter Rabbit.
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 Rabbit.
Peter Rabbit is the stupid book about the stupid rabbit who steals vegetables from other people's garden. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 83 to go.
The name of the book about which this book report is about is Peter Rabbit, which is about this rabbit. I found it very... I liked the part where... It was a... It reminded me of Robin Hood.
And the part where Little John jumped from the rock to the Sheriff of Nottingham's back. And then Robin and everyone sprung from the trees in a sudden surprise attack. And they captured the Sheriff and all of his goods, and they carried him back to this camp in the woods. And the Sheriff was guest at their dinner, and all but he wriggled away, and he sounded the call, and his men rushed in, and the arrows flew. Peter Rabbit did sort of that kind of thing, too.
The other people's name was McGregor. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23.
In examining a work such as Peter Rabbit, it is important that the superficial characteristics of its deceptively simple plot should not be allowed to blind the reader to the more substantial fabric of its deeper motivations. In this report, I plan to discuss the sociological implications of family pressures so great as to drive an otherwise moral rabbit to perform acts of thievery which he consciously knew were against the law. I also hope to explore the personality of Mr. McGregor in his conflicting roles as farmer and humanitarian. Peter Rabbit is established from the start as a benevolent hero.
If I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all. I'll get a fresh start tomorrow, and it's not due till Wednesday, so I'll have all of Tuesday unless something should happen. Why does this always happen? I should be outside playing, getting fresh air and sunshine. I work best under pressure, and there'll be lots of pressure if I wait till tomorrow. I should start writing now, but if I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all.
The name of the rabbit was Peter. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Ha!
Down came the staff on his head, smash! And Robin fell like a sack full of lead, crash! The Sheriff laughed and he left him for dead, ha! But he was wrong.
35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Just then an arrow flew in, whing! It was a sign for the fight to begin, whing! And then it looked like the Sheriff would win, ah! But not for long. Away they ran. Just like rabbits who run a lot, as you can tell from the story of Peter Rabbit, which this report is about.
How do they expect us to write a book report of any quality in just 2 days?
The extreme pressure exerted on him by his deeply rooted rivalry with Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail.
If I may start writing now,
the end. 94, 95. The very, very.
book report on Peter Rabbit.
That was the original cast of You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown on MGM Records. Gary Berghoff, who later became Radar O'Reilly in MASH in the movie and television series, played Charlie Brown. And that is just, I don't care. You know, you can be sophisticated if you're a Cole Porter or Noel Coward fan. You're obviously not going to necessarily dig Charlie Brown, but it is so smartly written. It is so clear and so respectful to the source and the characters. I think Book Report is just a fantastic piece of musical theater writing. This is Larry Maslon, your host of Broadway to Main Street. Today's show is called You've a Good Score, Charlie Brown, the many ways in which the Peanut Strip has influenced songwriters over the last 50, 60 years. Imagine my surprise when I heard, as a late teenager, maybe in college, that Irving Berlin had written a song called Suppertime for As Thousands Cheer in 1933. I always thought Suppertime was from You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, and sung by Snoopy. And here it is, sung by Bill Hinnant from the original production. Take it away, Snoopy.
My stomach clock just went off. It's supper time and Charlie Brown has forgotten to feed me. Here I lie, a withering hollow shell of a dog, and there sits my supper dish, empty. Well, that's all right. You'll remember. Tomorrow after school, when no little furry friend comes to greet him, then he'll remember. He'll rush out here to the doghouse, but it'll be too late. There'll be nothing left but the dry carcass of his former friend who used to run and play so happily with him. Nothing left but the bleached bones
of
the little canine.
Hey, Snoopy, are you asleep or something? I've been standing here for a whole minute with your supper dish and you haven't even noticed. Come on now, it's supper time.
Supper time? Supper time?
Brimming bowl of meat and meal, which is brought forth to ease our hunger. Behold the flowing flagon, moist and sweet, which has been sent to slake our thirst.
All right, there's no need for a big production. Just get down off of your doghouse and eat.
Oh, it's supper time, yes, supper time. Ooh, it's supper time, very best time of day. Supper time, yes, supper time. And when supper time comes, can supper be far away? Bring on the soup dish, bring on the cup, bring on the bacon and fill me up, cause it's supper time.
Do 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 you do do.
Bring on the dog food, bring on the bone, bring on the barrel and roll me home. Supper, super rubber, supper, super duper dupper time. Wintertime's nice with the ice and snow. Summertime's nice with a place to go. Bedtime, overtime, halftime too, but they just can't hold a candle to my supper time. Oh yeah! Bring on the hamburger, bring on the bun. Pepper's little puppy loves everyone. Cause it's supper. Super rubber, supper. Super duper dubber, doobie 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 doobie.
Can't you just eat your supper quietly and calmly like any normal dog?
So what's wrong with making mealtime a joyous occasion?
Well, many viewers who watched the Charlie Brown television animated series knew that Snoopy never talked. He never gave voice to any of his very intricate and, frankly, showbiz-laden thoughts. So it was great to have that in the musical version. So it was not long before people realized, the original producer of Your Good Man Charlie Brown, Arthur Whitelaw, realized you could do a sequel. And in 1975, there was a sequel, and it starred Snoopy, 2 exclamation points. And here is a character that was added who became prominent since the original Off-Broadway show, Peppermint Patty. And she sings a song to Charlie Brown, and it's Pamela Myers who gave the world Another 100 People from Company 5 years earlier. Great, great song. And we'll come back to more Snoopy. But here's Pam Myers in the meantime.
Chuck, what kind of a girl do you think you'll marry?
Well, I always kind of hate to talk about it. I'm afraid that it might sound silly. But I'd like the kind of girl that would call me Poor Sweet Baby.
Poor Sweet Baby.
Uh-huh. If I was feeling tired or depressed or something, she'd cuddle up close to me and kiss me on the ear and whisper, Poor Sweet Baby.
Poor Sweet Baby. Poor, poor, sweet, sweet baby. Show me where it hurts, I'll tell you how to make it well. I've won lots of loving cups for playing show and tell. My poor sweet baby. Poor, poor, sweet, sweet baby. When you need a shoulder, come and try mine on for size. I'm real good at holding hands and really great at drying eyes. Just try me, cry me all your tears. Why deny me the pleasure of drying them? Stop. Despair, for smiles are what I'm there for. You won't have to call on me, I'll always be right near, there to kiss and cuddle you and whisper in your little ear, don't fear. Like that, Chuck?
Just like that, Patty.
Forget it. It'll never happen.
So we're into Snoopy, 2 exclamation points, the musical, Off-Broadway. Unfortunately, we don't have David Garrison, who was the original Off-Broadway Snoopy, in a recording. But we'll go with the cast we have. This is the London cast. They sing a great song, a great trio, and the score was by Hal Hackety and Larry Grossman, who wrote Minnie's Boys and Good Time Charlie and some other stuff. Very, very good composers. Here are the 3 Peanuts ladies to give you a version of what they've learned in their all too brief but encyclopedic life.
I know now that you can't bend a cracker. No matter how hard you try, you may try. I know now that your body isn't leaking when you cry, when you cry. I know now that a smile makes a lousy umbrella. Snoopy, go home. I know now we should not try to sing a cappella. I know now that you can trust a daisy. They blab every chance they get. I know now it's impossible to rain a violet.
Wish I knew where Mom was. Beautiful moments are meant to be shared. I'm gonna be the big bow wow. Wait till they see the old dog now. Stealing the show, my mom wouldn't know her pup. I'm gonna be a VIP. Hey, look at me, a VIP. Thoroughbred sort, a very important pup. Three, no, two, no. I'm numero uno. Are they ready for you? No, who? I'm gonna be the big bow wow. You're gonna see them all kowtow. Name on my door, a rug on my floor. And now, no longer hey, step aside, runt. Flashing my profile from side front. Now I'm the big bow wow. Class, yes. Style, yes. Out front by a mile, yes. Look me up in your dog's who's who. Gonna be hearing from Snoopy. Pardon my beagle, but whoopee. Now I'm the big bow wow.
Your heart out, Barbara Woodhouse. Lights, camera,
was Teddy Kepner as the title character Snoopy, another kind of reprise. Snoopy is a great, great character to write musical songs for. That was from Snoopy the Musical. Well, Your Good Man Charlie Brown ran 4 years off-Broadway, briefly moved to Broadway in the early 70s, flopped, was done for television live, was animated, So it was only a matter of time in 1999, in fact, when it was revived for Broadway with an interesting and expanded cast. Andrew Lippa added to the score, written by Clark Gessner, and a young girl playing Sally, named Kristen Chenoweth, took the town by storm and won a Tony Award for Best Supporting Actress in a Musical.
Oh, yeah? That's what you think.
What?
That's my new philosophy. Oh, yeah? That's what you think.
Well, why are you telling me?
What?
Why are you telling me?
Why are you telling me? I like it! That's a good philosophy. Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me? My new philosophy. The teacher gave a D on last week's homework. She said, Miss Sally Brown, your grades are going down. I could have told her.
Your new philosophy.
My new philosophy. Miss B? I'm she.
Look, C.
A D? A D. Well, why are you telling me?
And that's my new philosophy.
That's your new philosophy.
Why are you telling me?
My new philosophy.
That's great, Sally, but I've got to go practice Chopin's Nocturne in B-flat minor.
No! I like it. No! That's a good philosophy. No! No! No!
That's your new philosophy, huh?
Yes! I mean, no!
Just like a busy bee, each new philosophy
are simple. Man does not live by bread alone. Some philosophies are clear.
Leave your message at the sound of the tone.
Some philosophies pick and choose, deciding what goes in it.
Some take a lifetime.
Mine take a minute.
But Sally, anything that takes only a minute can't be very lasting. For instance, Beethoven took over 2 years to complete his brilliant Ninth Symphony.
No!
I can't stand it!
I can't stand it! I like it!
It's like a guarantee, my new philosophy. And things are sure to be a whole lot brighter.
Oh yeah? That's what you think. Why are you telling me? No! I can't stand it!
Now life is free and easy. Much more philosophy with my brand new.
You know, someone has said that we should live each day as if it were the last. Some philosophies aren't for all people.
And that's my new philosophy!
Kristen Chenoweth from the revival of You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. Well, one of the reasons I got interested in this material again is a release of an album, or the re-release of an album, called Norma Dolores Eggstrom from Jamestown, North Dakota. My goodness. And that's Peggy Lee. And she recorded a song written by the Sherman Brothers for the animated film Snoopy Goes Home, or Snoopy Come Home, in which Snoopy runs away or leaves Charlie Brown to become the head beagle. And it may be the saddest song I've ever heard in my life, but she sings it impeccably. Another great song inspired by the Peanuts crowd.
When you think that you know where you stand, you've got the world in your hand. Just when you're sure of a dream that you planned, that's when the scenery changes. You changes. Just when you think that you know all the facts, you hold a whole ball of wax. You've got it made, you can start to relax. That's when your world rearranges and changes. Someone that you really cared about, someone that you couldn't live without, severs the tie. All at once you're all alone and scared. All the happy hellos that you shared change to goodbye. Why must we pay for hellos that we say? Pay when we sigh and adieu. Just when you're sure and you're safe and secure, that's when it happens to you. It changes. Why can't we get together with all the people in the world we really like, and then just stay together forever? But someone would leave. Someone always leaves. And then we'd have to say goodbye. I hate goodbye. Why must we pay for hellos that we say? Pay when we sigh and adieu. Just when you're sure and you're safe and secure, that's when it happens to you. It changes. Why, oh, why? What we need are more hellos.
Oh, my goodness. Don't watch the film clip. You'll be a wreck for the rest of the week, if not the month. This is Larry Mazlon, your host. I'm so happy that you spent some time with me and my childhood delight of the Peanuts crowd and the American musical and the brilliant way I think they came together over the last half decade. So in that spirit of happiness, we will close out with the 1999 Broadway cast. And you know what song I'm going to play.
I'm so happy. That little red-haired girl dropped her pencil. It has teeth marks all over it. She nibbles her pencil. She's human. It hasn't been such a bad day after all. Happiness is finding a pencil.
Pizza with sausage.
Telling the time.
Happiness is learning to whistle.
Tying your shoe for the very first time.
Happiness is playing the drum in your arms.
And happiness is walking hand in hand. happiness is two kinds of ice cream.
Knowing a secret.
Climbing a tree.
Happiness is five different crayons.
Catching a firefly, setting him free.
Happiness is being alone every now and then.
And happiness is coming home again.
Happiness is morning and evening, daytime and nighttime too. For happiness is anyone and anything at all that's loved by you.
Happiness is having a sister,
sharing a sandwich,
getting along. Happiness is singing together when day is through. And happiness is those who sing with you.
That's loved by you.
You're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some the time.